I've pulled out my 49 and Market Create an Album components, and this time I'm combining them with the Christmas Spectacular collection. In today's video, I'll show you some options for working with the pages, the waterfall enclosures, and binder mechanisms. We're fully stocked with all elements of Create an Album and have the entire line on sale reduced by 25%. In addition, we have both the Nature Study and Spectrum Gardenia collections on sale, also at 25% off. Links to the products can be found in the expanded description below. This is my second video about the Create an Album line. Today I'm working with both tall and wide journals, and this is the tall one with Christmas Spectacular. I've got the wide off to the side. But rather than use the accordion spine with the pages attached to it, I'm using the binder mechanisms and the punch, the waterfall enclosures, and I brought in Christmas Spectacular as kind of my focal collection. So just briefly, this is the one that I created in the first video, and you can see that this accordion spine with all the pages attached and some fold-outs and those kind of fun things is what I did the first time. So this time, instead, what I'm doing is I'm using these binder mechanisms. So they are available in both black and white. They are two to a pack. So for the tall album, which is what this is, technically, if I'd wanted, let me grab the other black one, if I'd wanted to arrange these like this so that I had this double set and I would have four holes punched in each page, I could, but I went the small route instead. Now when you work with the wide version, and this is the wide one I'm kind of playing with, you really can only fit one in here. But with that said, something that you can do, and in fact my friend Laura mentioned this, I had started by putting one of these here. Well, let's do it this way because I would have been working with the portrait version at that point. So I would have put one here. And then I was thinking that I wanted to put one up top here, but ultimately when you close this, they're going to bump into each other. But the other option is that you can put one at the top and the bottom, so you can flip one way and you can flip the other. Now, I didn't do that, but I want you to think about the fact that there's lots of ways that you can arrange these things. What I would suggest is that you use some repositionable adhesive and you maybe put these binder mechanisms where you want them to be, and then try closing the journal to make sure that they don't interfere with each other, because I did run into that at one point. So this is the punch, and this is the standard distance, and I think it's 2 3/4 inches. This is the US standard for these kind of two-hole punches, so you can use this on anything that requires a two-hole punch. That little piece right there, when you push it in, it pops out, and that's how you open the punch, and then you just push to close it again afterward. It just makes storage a little bit easier. So attaching these binder mechanisms is actually pretty easy. I've only got one here, and I've already got it in place, but what you do is you can see the backside of this is very flat and very smooth. Now what you want to be careful of, what you want to be careful of is that you don't put any adhesive on here that's going to interfere with this movement. So if you look at this, and I'm not going to put this on, but let's just tear this so you kind of get the sense of what I'm doing here. If you look at this, you can see that this will fit right on here. So you peel this off the backing paper, the adhesive is on here, you stick it on the back, and then when you're ready, you can reposition it. Now, remember that this kind of sticky stuff is one and done. The way that you can kind of work around that and give yourself a little flexibility is to use an adhesive that is a liquid adhesive. I wouldn't use a bunch, but you can certainly use some, and that'll allow you a little bit of maneuvering room when it comes time to place this. Let me bring in the portrait version for one sec. Excuse me, for one second. So these are all 6x8 pages from the 6x8 paper pack, and it works perfectly because they are sized to fit in here. Wow. They are sized to fit in here just like this. You don't have to do anything to them. Now this is one of the fold-outs, and I'll come back to this in a second, but when you start to work with these 6x8 pages in the tall version of the journal, it's very straightforward. But something that's really cool with Christmas Spectacular is that it has both horizontal and vertically oriented pages. So for example here, this is something else I'll show you in a second. I could punch this and it's ready to go and it's oriented horizontally. We'll come back to this in one second. With that said, if you take a vertical page and you orient it this way, I don't think anybody's really going to notice, especially by the time you get through adding to these pages. And so I wouldn't sweat that too much. Now, with all of that said, if I were to take this vertically oriented page and I cut up 6 inches for the bottom, I have a 6x6, and we'll just kind of pretend that this isn't here. I have this 6x6 page that is sized just like this, and I can go ahead and punch the holes in it. So now I've taken, well, this is turned toward me. Now that I've taken something that was oriented the other way, and I've cut it to the point where it now is oriented horizontally for this wide journal. And before I forget, when you look at these, the option is, this is the wide, it's oriented horizontally, and this is the tall, that's oriented vertically. Now you'll notice that these two have different width spines. This is the chunky version, and this is the standard version. And that just means that you have more room to fill up these pages with bulky things. And when you're talking about using the accordion business in the center to put all those pages on the standard one, you can get one width in here, but on the wide one, you can actually get two. And you'll see that, or you can see that in the other video that I did. I'll try to remember to link that in the description below. So with all of that said, the other option that I did work with, and let me bring these out. So when you have, these covers are all sold individually, and then there are pages. There are these wide book pages that are meant for this wide journal, and then there are the tall book pages that are meant for the tall journal. And what you can do is you can incorporate these two. Now you can put them in places, let's move some of this stuff. I've gotten to the point where you can't even see everything here anymore. You can orient these however you want. Again, I've got this turned toward me instead of turned toward you. And it's just a question of using these flip outs, and now you have all this room that you can create on. All I've gotten so far has been able to put the pages on there. And I'm going to talk about the waterfall enclosure in a second, but let's bring this other one in. Again, let's kind of clean up this mess a little bit. And again, oriented the wrong way. So here on the tall version, I have that same three fold-out piece. The only difference is that this one is oriented for the tall one, so it's oriented this way. Again, we have this. I've got pages. This is a no-brainer. These are easy. Everything is 6x8. However, if you come across a page that's horizontal, and let me see if I can find one here. If you come across a page that's horizontal and you want to put it in here, you actually can in the tall journal. Or you can trim it down again so that it's 6 inches wide, just the same way that I did for the other. So now let's talk about these waterfall enclosures. And let's actually look at one in its naked glory. So this happens to be a white 6x8. And you can see that this is the closure. You can see that what you get is all of these waterfalls that are all ready to go, and then you get this top flap and this that comes up and creates this unit. Now, that's pretty flat. But if you look at this, you can see that there are score marks here. And so if you score that, excuse me, if you fold that on the score and you fold this on the score, now you have the ability, and it's a little hard to hold because there's nothing in here forcing this, but now you have the ability to have this much thicker version, and then you can fill these pages, these waterfalls, this cascade, with stuff. And again, here, you can fold these in such a way so that you've got all this space in between. Again, these are pre-scored. This is how it comes built. So you have room to put really thick stuff in here too. And then you can accommodate all that thick stuff when you fold this up. And again, this is really hard to show. When you fold this up like this. And then when you are ready, so in my case, for this one, I came in, this is already attached, so I can't unattach it, but I came in and I did the fold thing just like I explained a second ago. Now this is, again, this is not fluffed up because there's really nothing inside yet, but it is ready to be fluffed up. I put a piece of paper here on the flap. I left the top piece black, and then on this bottom fold up, I did the same thing. I left the bottom piece uncovered, and then I just put it on here. And then for these bad boys, you can see that they just have, they've got the little legs. You just pull these down, poke a little tiny hole in there, feed the feet through, fold them over, and now if I wanted to cover this, I could actually cover this too so I wouldn't see it, and then the same thing here on the inside. So in addition to the 6x8, there are two 4x6 size waterfalls. If I could put, here they are, if I could put my hands on them. So these are adorable. They're these little fold-outs, and again, they're going to use the same size buttons to kind of close them up. You do the same thing. You fold on this score, and then here on the one on the bottom, so that you have the ability to have this be nice and chunky and have plenty of room for everything that's in there. Now, for what I have done, and again, let's come back to the one that I'm working on. For the wide, there are some options. So I could orient them two side by side like this. I could orient them both, well, I can't actually do that. I could put this one this way if I wanted, and then if I wanted to put one in the back, and again, we'll ignore the fact that I've got this fold out here. If I wanted to put them in the back, I could do that as well. The other thing that's interesting to note is this 6x8 fits horizontally in here. So if you wanted a fold out that was, again, I'm running out of space. If you wanted a fold out that was oriented this way, you absolutely have the ability to do that too. So I covered mine with paper. I haven't brought in any of the embellishments, but within the Christmas Spectacular line, there are lots and lots. There's the laser cut elements, there are all kinds of rub-ons in various sizes, there's ephemera, I can't even think of everything, but it is the traditional collection that you would expect from 49 and Market. Now, I have not worked with Spectrum Gardenia or with Nature Study in here, but they would be beautiful in here too. And I know that some people shy away from black, but I think, especially with Christmas Spectacular, the black is really, really beautiful, and I think that it would be equally beautiful because with Gardenia, which is so bright and has such vivid colors, it would work really well against this black. It would contrast really nicely. You can use any of the things that you want. In fact, if you want to bring collections that aren't 49 and Market, I'm not going to object, and I'm sure the folks there won't either. We want you to use these. We want you to create memories or a place to store your memories, and I think that this line of create an album elements is the perfect way to do that.